Number four.
Am I tripping? Oh, there it is. I was tripping. I don't see four. All right. Okay, what do we have to do? Find the slope and the y-intercept of the given equations. All right, this is review, but it should be easy, okay? The slope and y-intercept, if they want the y-intercept form, because slope and y-intercept, just solve for y. Okay? Move this over. 4y equals negative 3x plus 7. Right? Just take it and change the sign. Move it to the other side, change the sign. Simple. Or you can subtract 3x from both sides. It's up to you. This is pre-calc. We should know that we're just moving it over, changing the sign. Okay, next. Divide by 4, divide by 4, divide by 4. Please don't do the one line. The one line doesn't work for me because you guys always forget and you only divide one of them by it. And it's everybody on the block is a paper. Divide, divide, divide. Okay? Alright, so then negative 3/4 x plus 7/4. Okay? So what is my slope is negative 3/4 and my y-intercept is equal to 7/4. And I would like to see it as M and B. Alright? We're big boys and girls now. Let's do this. Alright. Next. 6. Alright. Does somebody want to read that to me? I'm not a big boy.
2 parentheses y minus 3 parentheses plus parentheses x minus 6 equals 4 parentheses x plus 1 minus 2.
Whoa. 4 parentheses x minus 1 and then minus 2? X plus 1?
Minus 2.
And then minus 2? Call it back, y'all. All right. We still got to solve for y. But in this case, we have to do a whole bunch of stuff first. Everybody on the block gets a paper. Okay? Everybody on the block gets a paper. Might as well do both sides at once. 2y minus 6 plus x minus 6. Then 4x plus 4 minus 2. Does everybody see that? Right? Then what do I do? Come on, someone help me out. What do I do next?
Combine like terms?
Yeah, you do! And like terms are?
2y plus x.
Good, 2y plus x, and then you'll say minus 12 because you combine those like terms. Good. And then here would be just 4x plus 2. Perfect, perfect. Good. Love it. Okay? Then what? Yeah, we gotta move the x's and the numbers over because we gotta solve for y, right? So this isn't the same as like move the lowest x. This is move the x because you want to keep the y positive. So we're just going to move the x over. Minus x no matter what. Even if this wasn't lower, we'd move it. Okay? Minus x. And I might as well kill two birds with one stone, right? We can pull up our jeans now, right? Or our dresses, kilts, whatever we're wearing. Shorts.
Boom. 2y is equal to 3x plus 14, right?
No.
Did I mess up? That good? Okay. Then what do I do? Divide by 2. Y is equal to 3 halves x plus 7. M is equal to 3 halves. And B is equal to 7. Okay. That's not bad. Let's try 8. Find the slope of the line through the given points. We got this all day long. In fact, 8's so easy, I'm going to do it right here. Okay? Can somebody read me those points, though?
Right.
Yeah.
Let's see, -1 and -2. Yeah. Let's see, -2, -1.
Okay. We do need to remember the formula, right? So there's one of two formulas. Dan's formula or the book, right? So the book formula, M is equal to Y sub 2 minus Y sub 1 over X sub 2 minus X sub 1. Yay, team. Dan formula, flip it. Negative 2 over negative 1, negative 1 over 2. Remember, the y is over the x, okay? So if you want, you can make these two different colors. So you can see which one went where. Flip it, okay? Flip it and smack it, okay? That means a smack and a smack and run. There's your M. Okay, so what is M equal? What's negative 2 minus minus 1? What's minus minus 1? Plus 1. So what's negative 2 plus 1? Okay, what's negative 1 minus 2? What's negative over a negative? There's your slope. And that's all they asked for? Slope?
Yeah.
That's cake. Got this all day.
What?
All right. So that'll take us to 8.